Hello guys, welcome to Amit Things. In this video, we will see how we can connect Python with MySQL. That means we will install MySQL connector on Windows 10 and we will connect both Python and MySQL. So let's begin guys. At first, we will download and install Python and pip, then we will install MySQL. Let's begin with the download and installation of Python and pip. Let's start.
At first, go to the browser. I am using Chrome, you can use any browser. Here in our Google, type Python and press enter. On pressing enter, you can see the official website is visible, python.org. Click on it. On clicking, you can see the official website. Whenever you will keep the mouse cursor on downloads, the recent version will be visible. So we want for Windows, so I'll click on it. This is the current version, Python 3.10.2. click on it. On clicking, the download started. It's only 26 MB. You need to wait for a few seconds. So guys, you can see the exe file downloaded. Now I'll double click on it to install. Minimize this. Now herein you can see the setup started. At first, set the Python 3.10 to path. So you can straight away click on install now. But I'll go for the customized installation. Click on it. On clicking, you can see it will install documentation, pip as well as IDLE. So pip is basically used to install other Python packages. Rest keep as it is and click on next. Herein you can see advanced option. You can click on install for all users. After clicking, you can see the path has been set. It's under program files. Our Python will get saved here. If you want to change the location, you can click on browse, but I'll keep as it is. Click on install. Now the setup started. So guys, you can see the setup is successful. Click on close.
So guys, we successfully installed Python and pip. Now let us install the current MySQL version. Let's begin. We will see how we can easily download and install MySQL Server 8.0.28 on Windows 10. With that, we will also install MySQL Workbench and Shell. So Shell is a command line tool that will allow you to create database and tables and work on MySQL on command line. So we will install all three. Let's begin. At first, go to the browser. I am using Chrome, you can use any browser. On Google search, type MySQL. Press enter. On pressing enter, you can see the official website is visible, mysql.com. Click on it. After clicking, go to downloads. After reaching downloads, go below. Here and click on MySQL Community GPL downloads. After reaching here, under community downloads, click on MySQL installer for Windows, because we want for Windows. Here you can see the current version is MySQL installer 8.0.28. The first one is a web installer and the second one is what we will download and install. It's 435 MB. You can see 32 bit is visible, but this works for both 32 bit as well as 64 bit. My system is 64 bit, as you can see here. Go to start, type about, click on open. Herein you can see my system is 64-bit operating system. Okay. Now we will download this. Click on it to download. You don't need to log in. Just click on no thanks. Just start my download. You can see the download started. 436 MB. You need to wait for a few seconds. Let's wait. So guys, it got downloaded. Now double click on it to install. Minimize this. Guys, the installation started. You need to choose a setup type. I'll go for the custom installation. Click on next. After clicking next, you can see you need to select the products. I told you I'll go for MySQL Server, so I'll just go to drop down. And here is the current one, 8.0.28. Just move it. Products to be installed section. Now go to applications. We wanted Workbench also. Here it is. Click on the following. The last one, what we wanted, guys, we wanted shell, which is command line, and just drag it here. So these three we wanted. So everything looks fine. Click on next. We need to click on execute to install all of them. Click on execute. So guys, you can see the installation completed. Click on next. Now it will configure the product. Click on next again. So guys, herein you can see Microsoft Visual redistributable package is also needed for MySQL installation. So since we are already having this on our system, it never showed us. So guys, we have mentioned a link in the description of this video using which you can easily install Microsoft Visual C++ redistributable package. After that, you will reach here. This is the port number. Everything looks fine. Click on next. Here in authentication method, keep the default strong password. Click on next. Let us add a password. So root is the admin. So that is why it is asking for MySQL root password. Let us set up password. So we use the following password. You can directly click on next here, or you can also add a new user. We are already having root user, but you can also add an additional user by clicking add user. Here inside the name, let's say my user is Amit, and set it as localhost because we are working on a local system. Role you can set as DB admin on any other. Let's say I've set it as DB manager. Create a password for this new Amit user and click on OK. This will create a new user, but I'll click on cancel because root user is fine for me. You can continue with this. Remember this password, this will be required later. Click on next. Now you can see Windows service MySQL 80. It will start the MySQL server at system startup. Everything looks fine. Click on next. Now apply configuration step is visible. All the steps will occur and your MySQL server shell and workbench will install completely. Click on execute. This will also initialize the database. It will start the server also, as well as work on all the security settings and other stuff, configuration and everything else. Let's wait. Guys, you can see here MySQL 8.0.28 configuration successful. The installation is complete. Click on finish. Here is the product configuration. Click on next. You can see installation complete. When I'll click finish, it will start MySQL workbench and MySQL shell. But before that, let us set the path. At first, we will see the location wherein MySQL installed. It was in C drive, program files. Herein you can see MySQL is visible. Click on it. Here it is, MySQL server 8.0 bin. And this is it. Right click and copy. Minimize this. Go to start, type environment variables. On typing, edit the system environment variables is visible. This is what we wanted. Click on open. After clicking system properties, advanced, click on environment variables. Herein guys, you can see path is visible. Double click on it. Herein all the paths are set up. Click on new, right click and paste the same path. So we pasted the MySQL server bin path. That's it. Click on OK. Click on OK and click on last OK. That's it. We have set the path. Now I'll click on finish. It will start the MySQL workbench as well as shell. Click on finish. Here it is. You can see the workbench is visible. Okay, and the shell is here. Now let us go to start. Type cmd. Click on open to open it. Here it is. Here it is. Now type a command MySQL space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. Here you can see we successfully installed MySQL. The same is visible, 8.0.28. Now let us set a command MySQL hyphen u root hyphen p. Minus u is for user. So we were having root user. That's why I typed it. P is for password. When you will press enter, it will ask you to enter the password which we entered before. Enter the same password. Now press enter. If this is visible, that means you have successfully installed MySQL and you have started MySQL server. Okay guys, herein you can see I'll just type show databases semicolon, press enter. You can see these are the default databases provided by MySQL. Now let us create a database quickly. Create database AmitDB, let's say, semicolon, press enter, and it got created. This means one row affected, it got created. Now use the show databases command, semicolon, and press enter. Herein you can see AmitDB database got created. In this way you can create new databases and tables. With that, let us go to MySQL Workbench. Just click on this. You can see root is visible. When you click on this, it will ask you to add the same password we added before under root. Add the same password. Save it and click on OK. And you can see MySQL Workbench started. Through this also, you can easily create a new database, tables, and work on other operations, clauses, operators, everything else. So guys, we successfully installed MySQL as well. Now let us verify. Go to start, type cmd, click on open to open it. Now let us type MySQL space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. Here you can see we successfully installed MySQL. Now let us check for Python space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. You can see we successfully installed Python also. Now check for pip, pip space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. You can see we successfully installed pip also. Now guys, let us go to start and type IDLE, that is Python IDLE. I have told you before, click on open. So here it is guys. So guys, we need to connect Python with MySQL. So let us type, let us import mysql.connector, press enter. Now you can see it is showing an error. Why? Because we haven't connected both of them. We haven't installed anything for the connection. So we will install MySQL connector quickly. On the command prompt only guys, type the command pip install MySQL hyphen connector hyphen Python and press enter. So guys, you need to have an internet connection for this. Let's wait. It is downloading and installing the connector. Guys, we have successfully installed the MySQL connector. Now guys, let us go to start and type IDLE, that is Python IDLE. I have told you before, click on open. So guys, we have started our IDLE. Now let us create a new notepad here. Right click, text document. I'll just type example.py. Py is the extension for Python. When I'll press enter, it will change the text document. Here it is. Now here is our code. I'll just right click and open it. So I've opened with notepad. Now let us write a code. Here it is guys. I'll just save it. Okay, now I'll go to file and I'll open the file, the same file on the desktop. Here it is, example.py. You can see, I'll just click on run. Now herein you can see connection established. Here is the code. First we imported mysql.connector. So it was successful because we just installed it using pip. We used a variable con and the connect method. Within that, we are having three parameters to connect, that is host, which is localhost, password and user are the same, which we saw while installing MySQL. So I did the same password and user. If you remember, root was our user. Then we went for isConnected method to check it using if statement, that whether we have connected Python and MySQL successfully or not. And here we did that and the output we just saw, connection established. Here it is guys. So guys, in this video we saw how we can easily connect Python with MySQL using the connector. First we installed Python, then we installed MySQL, then we connected both of them. So guys, thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, Do subscribe to our channel, Amit Thinks.